हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम कोमल मेहता, टीचिंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन कंप्यूटर साइंस डिपार्टमेंट एट सेंट एंड्रयूज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, गुड़गांव। टुडे इन द कोर्स ऑफ वेब डेवलपमेंट वी विल कवर अबाउट द फ्रेम क्रिएशन एंड सम बेसिक लेआउट अबाउट द फ्रेमिंग। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फ्रेम क्रिएशन एंड द लेआउट। बेसिकली HTML फ्रेम्स आर used to divide a web browser window into multiple sections where each section can be loaded separately, because this will be done with the help of wait a sec can yeah I hope this is clear now. So we can say, to creating multiple sections in a singular window, we have to do it with the help of framing, so that there are multiple columns created, or we can say multiple section created, and each section is doing individual work, or we can say loaded separately. So a frame set tag is used for the collection of a frames in the browser window, and the frame set tag combines all the frames within the singular window. So to creating a frame, we will use how? Let's start this one. Instead of using the body tag, we use frame set tag in HTML to use the frames in the web browser. It is a tag deprecated in HTML5. HTML5 is the latest version of the HTML. So in HTML5, we will use the frame set tag for the multiple sections, not used in a body tag. The frame set tag basically used to define how to divide the browser. It means splitting in what manner will be done in this tag. In each frame that indicate by the frame tag, and basically defining which HTML document shall open in this frame. It means, because there are so many multiple frames created in a singular window, so which frame will be open, which content that will be mentioning with the help of this tag. To defining the horizontal frame, that means using in a row attribute, then use row attribute of a frame tag. And if we want a vertical frame, then we have to use the column attribute. And for that, col attribute is used for the frame tag in HTML document. So whenever we have to create any frame set, then we have to use frame set tag. And if we want to split in a row pattern, and then use the row attribute. And if we want to insert in a column pattern, then we will use the col attribute. Here is one example over here that will clear about this topic. So attributes basically calls cols. This attribute is used to create vertical frame in the web browser, right? So this attribute is basically used to defining the number of columns and its size inside the frame set tag. Here the size or a width of a column is set with the help of values, and that values will be represented in a pixel format. We can also do it in a percentage format. It doesn't matter, but basically in a standard format, the pixel is used. So in the first example, you can see here, frame set tag is started. After that, we will splitting in a column format. So col attribute is used with the frame set tag. Then the value is 300, 400 and 300 again. So this is the width, height, width and the height of a any frame. So we can also use the percentage value. In percentage value, we will represent the 30%, 40% and the 30% again. But in using the wildcard, that wildcard means asterisk. Asterisk is over here. So that will contain 30%, asterisk and the 30%. So that is the standard format. So the row attribute is also used to creating the horizontal frames in the web browser, and that defining the number of rows and the size inside the frame tag. We can also insert the border of the frame anywhere, because it is similar to the tabular format. We can say that is a grid format with row and columns, and border is also inserted in table. So in similar manner, we can also insert border with the frame tag. So this attribute of frame set tag defining the width of a border of each frame within the pixel. And zero value means no border, because whenever we have to insert any value, then that much width will be taken as a border. And if no value is mentioned, then value no value means no border. So the border has a two attribute, that is frame border and frame spacing. This attribute of a frame set is used to specify whether the three-dimensional border should be displayed between frames or not, and that will vary according to 0 and 1 value. 0 means no border, 1 means signifying the border, there will be some border must within the frames. Next is a frame spacing. Frame spacing means this attribute of a frame set tag is used to specify the amount of spacing between the frames in a frame set, because in singular frame set there are multiple frames or multiple sections, we can say, and the spacing between each frame will be mentioned with the help of frame spacing tag. So this will take an integer value as a parameter, which basically denotes that particular value of a pixel format is getting that much space within the frames. So the attributes of the frame tag is firstly name, that means defining the name of a frame. It differentiating one frame to the another frame, because all frames are looking similar. So how to differentiate these both will be mentioning with the help of particular name. So each frame has a name, and that name containing some source, that source containing the defining basically the source file where the we can say frame will be loaded. So to loading that particular frame, we need a source or a URL, we can say, that was defining in the source tag. So it differentiates one frame from the another frame. It is used to indicate which frame a document should load it into. And the source attribute here is, this attribute in a frame tag is basically used to define the source file, as I told earlier, that should be loaded into the frame. So the value of SRC must be any URL, and that URL defining the source file of the frame where we can load that particular frame. So it can also be possible frame name is here it is top, here it is left. Next is source containing some path. After that, margin width. Margin width is also the attribute in a frame tag that is used to defining the width of a space in the pixel between border and the content of left and right frame. Because whenever we have creating any frame, then one box is created, and after the box is created, we will create another frames, multiple small frames within that, and in that frames we will write out something. So the spacing between the frame and the text we will write in the left or in the right. So that spacing is mentioned with the help of margin width. Next is a scroll bar. Scroll bar is to control the appearance of scroll bar, that helps in the appearance effector. That means controlling the appearance of the scroll bar. That means we want to show how much will be done with the help of scroll bar. The value of this attribute can be yes, no, and automatically. Where the no value indicates there is no appearance of the scroll bar. And if yes, then the scroll bar is mentioned. And if automatically, then also scroll bar is mentioned and move accordingly by default feature. So the basic advantages of the frame is it allow the user to view multiple document within a single web page, because it's splitting the web window into multiple sections. It load pages from different server in a single frame set. The older browser does not support that much because it is only supported with the help of HTML5. So the disadvantage over here is, due to some disadvantage, that is, a frame can make the production of website complicated, because that will create complications. Sometimes we can't understand the frame we want to use is which one. A user is unable to bookmark any of the web page viewed in the frame, because that is mentioning in singular window, so we can't bookmark individual frame. So a user is unable to bookmark. Next is, the browser back button might not work as the user hope, because once we will reach, we will can't move back. We have to cross that window. The use of too many frames can put a high overload on a server, and even most difficult to understand as well. And it is not supported by the old browser. It is only supported by the HTML5. So the frame tag defining one particular window, that frame within a frame set. Each frame in a frame set can have different attribute, their border, their scrolling, their ability to resize, etc. A simple three frame structure is this one. Here you can see frame set call column ko स्प्लिट किया है इस क्राइटेरिया के बेसिस पर. देन हमने फ्रेम का सोर्स दिया. आफ्टर द फ्रेम सोर्सिंग फ्रेम ए डॉट एच टी एम, इट मीन्स एच टी एम एल एक्सटेंशन. एंड नेक्स्ट इज अ फ्रेम बी, नेक्स्ट इज अ फ्रेम सी. सो थ्री फ्रेम आर इंसर्टेड इन अ सिंगुलर फ्रेम सेट. सो द फ्रेम सेट टैग इज डिफाइनिंग द फ्रेम सेट एंड द फ्रेम सेट एलिमेंट होल्ड वन और मोर फ्रेम्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ फ्रेम टैग. ईच फ्रेम एलिमेंट कैन होल्ड द सिंगुलर और अ सेपरेट डॉक्यूमेंट वी कैन से. सो द फ्रेम सेट डिफाइनिंग हाउ मेनी कॉलम्स और रोज देयर विल बी इन द फ्रेम सेट एंड हाउ मच परसेंटेज ऑफ द स्पेसिंग विल ऑक्यूपाई ईच स्पेस. So first one is the 25%, next is by default, and next is the 25%. So this is the criteria. With the help of that, we can create our frames, and that frames will be inserted in the particular manner. So this is all about how to create a frame, what is the basic layout, what are the basic attributes we will use in a frame set. Now, one activity is for you that try to make three columns within a single form and also include attributes in that frame so that you can get more clear vision of how we can create a frame within the singular frame. So this is all about frame set and the layout. The main basic key points here is what is the use of a frame set tag, what is the use of frame tag, how can we split in a row pattern and a column pattern, how can we mentioning any frame with it with the help of source tag. Is the source is mentioning the complete URL or the little one, it means relative and absolute concept is over here. So these are some basic key points that we have to know after the framing concept. I hope this is clear to all of you. Thank you.